it's me. Listen, I'm sorry for the things I said earlier on. It's just, God, I really don't think you should go to that place. I don't think they care. Not like they should. And before you think it, I know how it feels to want to feel safe, to want more. You know I do it, but Jesus, do you know how they view you? Just another patient to squeeze money out of. Please, don't go tonight. I'm freaking scared. For you and for me.
In the mid-19th century, advances in genetic and psychological sciences led to a series of astounding breakthroughs regarding the human genome. At the forefront of these experiments, the Ishin Initiative discovered and developed new ways of mapping the human mind, expanding the knowledge of our species. 1942. Whilst the world was at odds with itself, the Ishin Initiative discovered Patient Zero.
I'll administer the first injection. And now, this might cause some slight discomfort.
And shortly after, the Ether Institute was born. With it, a completely new way to navigate the human brain. Projection. Allowing scientists to access areas of the conscious mind previously undiscovered by medicine. In the mid-19th century, advances in genetic and psychological sciences led to a series of astounding breakthroughs regarding the human genome.
I might have to listen to this again.
At the forefront of these experiments, the Ishin Initiative discovered and developed new ways of mapping the human mind, expanding the knowledge of our species. 1942. Whilst the world was at odds with itself, the Ishin Initiative discovered Patient Zero.
You'll sleep. I'll administer the first injection. And now, this might cause some slight discomfort.
And shortly after, the Ether Institute was born. With it, a completely new way to navigate the human brain. Projection. Allowing scientists to access areas of the conscious mind previously undiscovered by medicine, placing our scientific studies at the apex of modern technology.
Never a good sign.
is excellent. We're so glad to have you back. My name is Dr. Edmonds, but you can call me Phyllis if you like. Right. There should be a register on the reception desk. So once you've signed in, grab the key card from the top drawer and head on down. You will need it to gain access to the lower floors.
Restoration procedure for patient
JN20057
will commence shortly. Staff are advised to prepare chambers for initial projection.
Well, it seems you best get a move on. There's plenty to do, and for you, plenty to see and discover. I'm going to be guiding you through the process of restoration this evening, and hopefully ensuring that nothing terrible happens to you or our client. I'm in restoration chamber number 3. Now, if you don't mind, would you be a dear and head on down?
This is shady. I'm already in it.
Restorer. The next step in human evolution, an asset to society and a wonder of the natural world. Their purpose? To restructure memories within the maze of the human mind, restoring peace and harmony to our clients. Projecting our ethos through their actions, what the mind thinks, the heart transmits.
And that's written restoration chamber 3 that's prepared to you. Oh, that is one of the most idiotic things I have seen. Restoration chamber number 3.
restorer.
Observation, most likely. Why is this open?
You know, we do tell them not to leave the pre-designated path, to stick to the memory routes laid out for them. But do they listen? Of course they bloody well don't. And unfortunately, recovery isn't always an option once you experience the deep recesses of another consciousness. Of others and a tool to cure disease and illness. But it would be nothing without the likes of you. Right. Would you be a dear and help me with the setup? I need the electrical input for the Rembrandt installation rerouting. You can access it from that terminal over there. Replace the fuse. You'll need to take the blown one out and replace it with the correct fuse. By the computers over there. Okay. currently in a very delicate state. Our primary focus is to ensure that we clear this area of her mind from the plaque buildup that is causing the disease. In order to do that from within, we're going to need to use her own memories to reinforce the medical treatment she's receiving. Surroundings. It keeps most restorers' sanity intact. For a short while, anyway. Our sole purpose this evening is to track the memory and pinpoint its location so we can cleanse it of any disease present. Everything you're seeing in front of you is a visual environment pieced together from our client's subconscious mind. Barren wastelands or an abstract painting reimagined. It's all completely tangible. All I can see are brain scans of tissue degradation confirming my previous diagnosis of dementia. Both are incredibly important if we are to succeed and understand our client's needs. Now, if you just give me a second, I'll have some more details for you. free to explore in the meantime. It's worth noting that if you feel an item might be useful later on in your journey, and you have no use for it now, you can always store it in the case and collect it at any time.
This ranch is not something I can take. This is the mine. I think I should put mine stuff over here. Taking a spare gas mask just in case.
That the central focus of this memory is located below you, in an old abandoned mine known as Devlin. Entry 95D in our client's memory journal indicates that an accident occurred affecting them in a meaningful way.
That's not a good sign. Family or someone important to him died in the accident. That's interesting. I'm not sure.
Okay, so I've been digging a little deeper into our client's personal history, and I found details of a strong emotional response to someone who once worked within the mine. An entry that discusses the mine at great length, but doesn't discuss whom the individual was that worked there. Continue to work your way down, further into the mine. It seems the center of this memory is very much at the heart of these industrial ratways. I'll contact you if I gain any more information.
It's almost like whatever happened to you emerged there. I'm guessing this toad over here. Right. So right, left, left, right, left. Thank you.
Sounds, sights, and smells can help store memories forever.
A projector. I'm not sure how they got here, but I think they relate to our patient's history. Don't worry. You won't need these to progress this evening, as they're an optional task. But we should at least give this one a try. I'll store important notes like this downstairs in the case for you. They'll be there whenever you want to have a look at them.
Things we touch throughout our life can stay with us in the back of our minds.
Although broken and fragmented, they hold the key to remembering the way we were.
Oh, I hope that wasn't important.
Seems like it was empty anyway. Something wrong with this. have made things worse. That's interesting. Looks like that was the right thing to do.
A spray of perfume and it all comes flooding back.